poverty-stricken, full of ruins, with the townspeople too afraid to leave their own homes. Whoever does dare to walk
you
outside
mean you can't
is more
go
than
by
likely to
go wipe your ass, bruh. Is that what you saying? Damn, no wonder why they want to run through the border, bruh. I'll be running through that border till me and my damn kids. Look at them bodies. Rest in peace to all the brothers and sisters. Oh, that's sad for real. All right, y'all. We're going to rub the elephant for good luck, y'all. Good luck. What's up, y'all? It's your favorite homegirl. Today, you guys got some more music to react to. This ain't no music. This is 10 most dangerous places in the world, y'all. Damn, I see killers on the thumbnail. Killers. We gonna get straight to y'all. Y'all let me know how y'all feel. We gonna see if these are 10 most dangerous places, y'all. It better not have Ohio up in here because these some soft ass niggas down here. Let's go, y'all.
The Juarez Valley is a 40-mile stretch of cotton fields and ghost towns.
Yeah, enough space to hide bodies, Knuckle. That's what he's saying.
Runs along the Rio Grande and is just a few steps away from the 18-foot fence of the U.S. border. Dubbed the Murder Valley, it holds the title of the world's most dangerous place. The town, which used to have 60,000 members of its community, now has around 5,000 surviving.
Took out most of the residents. Damn, he said surviving residents. Damn.
Residents which live in fear. Run by the cartels, the streets are known for being regularly decorated with drugs, blood, and corpses. Juarez Valley averages 160 murders per 100,000 residents annually. The murder rate is incredibly high, not only due to the normality of crime, but also due to the fact that cartels are fighting over each other for control of the territory. The majority...
Hey, cartel don't play, man. Black Mafia don't either. Dayton Mafia, they don't play either. That's a damn shame. I'm from Dayton, y'all. I got family members in Dayton Mafia. I ain't even gonna lie to y'all, man. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. It is what it is. Like I said, I ain't in no gang, so I ain't worried about that shit.
If the shops have been closed for good, with gravestones lining the streets in remembrance of those who have been killed. The buildings are full of gang graffiti, a lot of them markers of how many have been murdered on the marked spots, serving as warnings to others. The entire town looks like a scene from a horror movie, poverty-stricken, full of ruins. With the townspeople too afraid to leave their own homes. Whoever does dare to walk outside is more than likely to...
You mean you can't go buy toilet paper to go wipe your ass, bruh? Is that what you saying? Damn, no wonder why they want to run through the border, bruh. I'll be running through that border till me and my damn kids. Look at them bodies. Rest in peace to all the brothers and sisters. Aw, that's sad for real.
End up being killed, tortured, or kidnapped. The police officers who were sent to intervene have been executed in 2009, and for fear of the wretchedness of the place, they have never been replaced. One of the few routes which connect the Amazon rainforest with the capital of that area of Bolivia is a road with a quite discouraging name, known as the Death Road.
Look at it.
The road was built by Paraguayan prisoners in the 1930s, and it underwent modernization about 20 years ago, beginning at 15,400 feet and taking the lives of approximately 300 people a year. It's quite surprising to find out that the Death Road is one of Bolivia's greatest tourist attractions.
I guess they want suicide, huh? They got a suicide mission. How is this exciting? Like, never. Dog, I ain't playing with my life. What did you tell?
Adrenaline seekers seem to be drawn to the deadly route, considered the world's most dangerous stretch of road. The 40-mile journey offers stunning views of the rolling hills of the Amazon rainforest, but is quite a feat for a mountain biker to undertake. It comes with a terrifying sheer drop into the canopy, as two rubber tires separate the rider from a narrow single-lane road. With very little in the way of railings, the thrilling downhill ride has taken 8
Who the fuck would ride a bike in it?
18 mountain biking enthusiasts' lives in the last 10 years. The North Anatolian Fault is an active fault, and quite a threatening one. Since the 1930s, devastating earthquakes have been moving westward throughout the land. The last big earthquake struck in 1999, with a 7.9 magnitude temblor devastating the city of Izmit. The death toll was a staggering number of 45,000. The fact that the wave of earthquakes is creeping westward is very worrying because the fault stretches 20 kilometers south of Istanbul, the largest city in Turkey. Istanbul is the country's economical, cultural, and historical heart. With a population of 14.4 million people, Istanbul is not only significant for Turkey, but for the world, as it is the world's fifth largest city, and the fault makes it one of the most dangerous places to live. Scientists expect that the next earthquake will shake the ground dangerously close to the city, with the possibility of triggering a series of small to moderate quakes. However, studies show that it's...
Damn, shit, you know all this. You better warn a nigga while they were about to happen. Shit, that's be scary. That shit'll be scary.
It's also possible the fault will create just one big, devastating shift in the ground, which could be the end of Istanbul and the death of millions. One of Africa's great lakes, Lake Kivu, is located along the border between the Democratic Republic of Congo and Rwanda, stretching across 2,700 square miles. The lake covers dangerous secrets. Below it, there are 2.3 trillion cubic feet of methane gas, alongside 60 cubic miles of carbon dioxide, trapped beneath the lake under the pressure of the water and the earth. If the gases were to be released from their trap, they would spread a lethal cloud over the whole area.
Hey, but do these citizens know that it's gas in that damn lake, and if it explode, we all dying? Damn. His commentary off the damn chain.
Meaning certain death for over 2 million Africans settled in the basin of Lake Kivu. In the 1980s, two similar African lakes released their toxic gases and resulted in the deaths of over 1,000 people. Scientists are concerned that the same fate awaits the residents of the Lake Kivu area, as it has similar chemical composition. Mm-hmm. The deadly toxins are caused by volcanic activities taking place hidden away underneath the massive lake. San Pedro Sula is a city in Honduras, located not far from the Caribbean Sea, with an estimated population of 1 million. It is the second largest city in Honduras. However, the city sadly has a negative reputation. In 2013, it has taken the title of the most dangerous city on the planet, stripping Mexico's Murder Valley of the title. That same year, upon claiming the title of the most violent place on the planet, the city had seen 187 homicides per 100,000 residents. The city is a major operational and strategic point for distribution of drugs and arms. With significant gang activity, it is the center of trafficking, providing the rest of the country with its 70% of illegal firearms, which in turn result in the 83% of the homicides. Labeled the murder capital of the world, San Pedro Sula is a place where tomorrow is always an uncertainty.
Look how these niggas just stacked in jail, sweat balls all over, smelling like booty, cigarettes. Like, bro, I would not want to go to jail there. I won't go to jail at all, but shit, dude.
If you venture about 90 miles off the coast of Sao Paulo, Brazil, you will likely come across a small chunk of uninhabited land called Ilha de Queimada Grande. This island is, in fact, one of the deadliest islands in the world. Also known as Snake Island, it is home to one of the most dangerous and poisonous snakes on the planet, the Golden Lancehead Viper. Local legends say that there are as much as 5 snakes per square meter, but in reality, there are about 2,000 of them on this 430,000 square meter island. Still, walking through it is more dangerous than a minefield. It is said that the stark and potent venom of the viper slowly paralyzes and liquefies the insides of the prey. But it has yet to be proven, as no one bitten has ever lived long enough to be admitted to a hospital. The sole inhabitant of this island was a lighthouse keeper who ran out of food and disappeared while trying to gather some bananas. According to legend, the members of his search party mysteriously vanished one by one, lost in the wilderness. Civilians are...
Was the bananas worth it? Was the bananas worth it?
Banned from the island, monitored by the Brazilian Navy, and the rules are bent very rarely for the sake of scientific research. Situated in the Huyan City, Mount Hua is known for its beautiful views and vistas, but also dangerous and deadly paths. Considered a holy place, Mount Hua is one of China's great five mountains. Monks and pilgrims made paths and staircases as ways to climb the mountains in order to reach the five peaks. However, the climb is not for the faint-hearted. The mountain is considered the most dangerous climb in the world. With time, the paths have been reinforced because of the incline in tourists venturing out and seeking adrenaline-inducing adventures.
Them crackheads. Them crackheads that got money and just want to explore and do dumb shit. There ain't no tourists, them crackheads.
But this mountain still remains one of the most difficult sites to conquer on Earth. The plank trail consists of wooden platforms, a bit over 2 feet wide, bolted onto the mountainside, and the only thing to secure oneself to it is an iron chain, which hovers freely in the air. And when the planks disappear, the only way to continue is by crossing steps on small divots carved into the mountain. Unfortunately, there are no exact statistics as to how many people die while on this path. But with local rumors naming about 100 deaths per year, the hike on Hua Shan surely lives up to its name, the deadliest hike in the world. The Danakil Depression lies at the heart of Ethiopia's ancient salt trade, where Ethiopians have been making the long 2-day trek to collect the salt for centuries, collecting it from the golden earth and bringing them back on camels. One of the hottest and harshest environments in the world, the sun and salt create amazing sun-blazed scenery, making the desert seem as if it were created out of white gold. The swirling sulfur and mineral salt formations create otherworldly scenery, creating an outlandish setting. One of the lowest
I bet this looks beautiful, especially looking up from the sky like an airplane or something.
Places on the planet, the Danakil Desert rarely sees rain and is one of the hottest spots on Earth, where rivers dry up and turn into lakes of salt. With magma crater lakes on its edges, products of active volcanoes, the desert proves to be an extreme challenge to human beings trying to cross it. The Mayak Complex was an area in Russia which served as secret headquarters for nuclear research and development. Most of the workers in the underground facilities were prisoners who agreed to work in such conditions in exchange for a lesser sentence. They were accompanied by leading Soviet nuclear scientists. Still, none of them survived to see freedom, as no one could survive such high-level radiation for more than 5 years. The Mayak experiment was the source of many nuclear disasters. The research proved lethal for the residents of the 24 villages along the banks of the river, as the radioactive waste had been dumped into the river, which was the source of drinking water for the villagers.
That is some trifling ass shit. That's the ghetto shit. That's some ghetto shit. You come to the ghetto, you gonna see that shit. Niggas just drinking whatever.
For 6 entire years. In 1957, a radioactive waste containment sector failed and exploded, the toxins affecting over 250,000 people in the area. The people were evacuated only 10 days later, after being already exposed. By 1959, every tree within a 12-mile radius was dead. All of this was covered up by the government, leaving the people clueless to the lethal dangers they were living beside. Based on the number of violent crimes per 1,000 residents, and taking into account how many of those have needed the involvement of the FBI, Camden has taken the title of the most dangerous city in the USA. Camden is situated in the state of New Jersey, on the east coast of the Delaware River. In the past year, Camden has seen 1,895 violent crimes, taking into account murder, rape, robbery, and aggravated assault. This might not sound like a great amount of crimes when compared to some other big cities. For example, Camden's neighbor across the river, Philadelphia, has seen 17,088 violent crimes last year. However, the key element that needs to be taken into consideration is the population of the city, which consequently leads to the average number of violent crimes per 1,000, which in Camden soars over the national average of 3.8 violent crimes per 1,000 people, with 25.66, more than 6 times the national average. This all leads to the conclusion that the chances of you becoming a victim of a violent crime is 1 in 39.
Make it make sense. Make it make fucking sense. 2 most dangerous places in the world, y'all. And they started off with Mexico and the cartel. Damn. Hey, Compton, like, where we at? Y'all niggas ain't even on the map. Fuck y'all. Damn, 10 most dangerous places in the world. They said they killers. And not only that, they got toxics and pollution and death roads and death traps and mountains and damn. But people be risking their own lives too, trying to be cool and trying to see shit that's beautiful. Fuck that shit. Cause then you dead, like you dead. What you gonna see next? Nothing, cause you dead. Y'all let me know how y'all feel about this down in the comments. 10 most dangerous places in the world. Smash the like button, hit that room. Y'all let me know something. Let go.